Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Helen with our new English lesson. Today, I have prepared a test for you for all the lessons we have taken till now. مساء الخير عليكم مع هيلين في الدرس الجديد. النهاردة هنعمله تيست صغير عن الدروس اللي فاتت عشان نشوفوا اتعلمنا ايه، يعني سنة تشوفوا اتعلمتوا ايه لغاية دلوقتي. Okay, let's go see what we have for today. So, we have today the test number two. This is for you today, the test number two. Number one says, introduce yourself. Introduce yourself, yani adım nafsak. And you will say your name, your age, your job. What do you do? What is your job? What is your name? Where do you live? Introduce yourself. يعني بتقدم نفسك. لما بتقدم نفسك بتقول اسمك، عملك، ساكن فين، جاي منين. Okay. Number two. Where do you live? عايش فين. Where do you live? عايش فين. Number three, do you speak English? هل أنت بتتكلم إنجليزي؟ Four, when do you study your lessons? When do you study your lessons? يعني إمتى في أي وقت؟ Do you study بتذاكر your lessons الدروس بتاعتك؟ Number five, at what time do you usually have your breakfast? At what time, Mr. Kim, do you usually, Damon, you have breakfast in the desert? Six, how do you go to your work every day? How is they? Because have to do the العمل بتاعك, your work every day, كل يوم. Seven, what is the name of your son? What is the name, ما هو اسم ابنك? Okay, your son, يعني ابنك. Eight, what is the name of your grandfather? Ma hawa ism jiddak, the grandfather. Who directs the job at your office? Who min directs yani bidir the job al amal fi al maktab bitaak fi al amal bitaak fi office. Number 10, what does a pilot do? A pilot, what is the job of the pilot? يعني pilot المضيف اللي هو الطيار بيعمل ايه? What is his job? What does he do? What is the work of the teacher? ما هو عمل المدرسة? What is the work of the teacher? The work of the teacher is to teach. Okay, there's an answer for you. Number 12, how do we call, ما هو اسم او احنا بنسمي اسمه ايه, the stuff, الشيء, we put in our money, اللي هي بنحط جوه الفلوس بتاعتنا, اسمه ايه. I will not tell you, will find it. Okay, انا مش هقول لكم, انتوا تدوروا على الاسم. Number 13, what is the name of the set? Set يعني طقم, men, الرجالة, were with the shoe, with the duk, in their wedding. يوم الفرح ما هو الاسم الطقم اللي هم بيلبسوه. Okay? Go back to the other lessons and you will find it. Okay? إن لو رحت للدروس القديمة هتلاقيه. Number 14. What do you wear? أنت بترتدي إيه؟ When you go to bed, لما بتروح للنوم. When you go to bed, what do you wear? Number 15. How do we call the suit that ladies wear in their wedding day? اسمه ايه اللبس او البدله اللي يلبسوها السيدات in their wedding day يعني في يوم فرحهم. The suit يعني بدله. That ladies السيدات wear يعني بيرتدوا in their wedding day في يوم فرحهم. What is the name of the suit they are wearing? 16. What is the name of clothing you wear around your neck? ما هو اسم النوع من اللبس اللي انت بتحطه حوالين رقبتك؟ اسمه ايه؟ round يعني حوالين. حوالين الرقبة. Neck hair الرقبة. You know from the old lessons. Okay. I will read the questions again. Number one. I want you to introduce yourself. Introduce yourself. I will introduce myself. My name is Helen. I am a teacher. I live in Greece. I work as a teacher. I have three kids. Okay, that's how you introduce yourself. Number two, where do you live? عايش فين? Three, do you speak English? Four, when do you study your lessons? Five, at what time do you usually have your breakfast? Six, how do you go to your work every day? How do you go to your work every day? I go to my work by bus, okay? What is the name of your son? What is the name of your grandfather? Who directs the job at your office? What does a pilot do? What is the work of the teacher? How do we call the stuff we put in our money? 13. What is the name of the set men were in their wedding? ما هو اسم البدلة أو الطقم اللي بيلبسوها الرجالة في فرحهم؟ Wedding يعني فرح. Okay. What do you wear when you go to bed? 15. How do we call the suit that ladies wear in their wedding day? And 16. What is the name of clothing you wear around your neck? Okay, let's go to the next. Now here we are going, you are going to say, when do we use the simple present tense? When? إمتى بنستعملوا the simple present tense اللي هو الحاضر البسيط, the simple present tense. Number two, I want you to give the plural يعني هتعمل اللي هو plural الجمع of the following words. The following يعني اللي هي جاية بعد كده, following words كلمات يعني بعد الكلمات اللي بعدنا بعد ده. So here I want you to write the plural of pen, book, child, television, penny, watch, radio, shelf, pillow, pillow المخدة, if you remember, fly, يعني الدبانة حاجة بتطير, we say fly, if you fly, دبان أو ناموس, fly, boy, box, house, fish, hobby, story, thief, wife, and the loaf. A loaf of bread, اللي هو رغيف, رغيف, loaf of bread. A loaf of bread, يعني رغيف, ايش. You know, pen is easy, book is easy, child, يعني طفل, television, you know, television, penny, اللي هي الفلوس اللي هي المعدنية, penny, watch, watch, يعني بتفرج, أو الساعة, بيتكتب بنفس الطريقة, watch, radio, shelf, اللي هو الرف, shelf, الرف, pillow, المخدة, fly, دبانة, boy, you know the boy, box, you know the box, house, you know, fish, السمك, hobby, يعني اللي هي لما بيكون عندك غية تعمل حاجة, hobby, story, story يعني قصة, thief الحرامي, wife الزوجة, and loaf اللي هو رغيف. Okay, number three, I want you here in this exercise, في التمرين ده هتحطوا put an A or N. You put A or N. House, man, woman, umbrella, exercise, alarm, English, apple, tree, girl, pupil, desk, question, hat, word, letter. The house, we know the house, man, we know the man, woman, we know, umbrella, we know, exercise, we know, alarm, المنبه, English, apple, apple التفاحة, tree, هي الشجرة, girl, pupil, pupil يعني تلميذ, desk, question, hat, word يعني كلمة, letter اللي هو الحرف, word الكلمة, letter الحرف. Okay, give the plural of these words, the plural, الجمع, هنا هتحط الجمع, a man, a woman, child, foot, foot اللي هي erect, tooth اللي هو الدرس, mouse الفار, goose اللي هي البتة أو الوزة, that is, I want the plural of that is and this is. If you go back to the old lessons, you will find it or you will remember, okay? So, when do we use the simple present tense? I want you to answer here this question. بتقولوا امتى بنستعملوا the simple present tense, okay? Number two, you are going to give the plural of the following words, the plural of these words. For example, I will choose for you a word here. The word penny becomes pennies. Okay? Penny becomes pennies. One more. I'll give you one more just for you. Loaf becomes loaves. A loaf of bread, loaves of bread. Okay? Now here you are going to put an A or an N. Here we put an A or an N. A and N. Okay? House, man, women, umbrella, exercise, alarm, English, apple, tree, girl, pupil, desk, question, hat, word, letter. Here, I want the plural. Give the plural of these words. Man, woman, child, foot, tooth, mouse, goose. That is, and this is. What is the plural of that is and this is? Okay, so we go to the next. Here I want you to write some names of animals. We had a lesson with animals, I want you, okay? And then go back to the other lesson, but then erga l-ders. Then you should flow kadab to mazbut. Number two, describe your house. I want you to describe, Yusuf, المنزل بتاعك. Describe your house. Okay? Describe your house. Number three, write the names of stuff in the kitchen. Here, I want you to write adjective أسامي أشياء اللي هي جوه في المطبخ. Okay. Number four, make sentences with the names أسامي of stuff that الأشياء or verbs أو اللي هي القواعد we use بنستعمله while cooking لما بنطبخ. For example, ديكو أنا مثلا I blend the fruits in the blender. Blend is a verb and you blend the fruits, the verb is a blend, the fruits in the blender, blender is the name, the noun. Okay. Here, answer the questions. How do you peel the potatoes? Remember this lesson in the kitchen? How do you peel the potatoes with Asher is there in potatoes? On what do you cut? Alei, bitata, cut or slice, bitata of tam sharayah, the meat, lahma. Bitata, alei, tam sharayah, how heta, the meat, bitata, alei. How do you squeeze zay, bitata, the oranges and lemons. Okay, what is the name of the thing you use to squeeze the oranges and lemons? Four, what do you use with the stem and A? عشان to blend, عشان تخلط the fruits, الفاكهة. What do you use to blend the fruits? Number five, how do you weigh, يعني بنوزن, the sugar, or flour will be when you make a cake with the Zenhom Zay. Okay? Here you are going to make sentences at Amelugoman with these verbs, with verbs dol, with kawai dol, of kalimati, rinse, rinse, yani nesto, serve, yani negre, cover, yani vingati, melt, yani vinsaya, crush, yani vinkasa, decorate, yani vinzawa, add, yani vindir, cut, bineta, fry, bineli, taste, bindu, drain, yani vinsafi, roast, yani vineshwi, measure, bin is, pour, yani vinsob, toast, vitamin toast, slice, yani sharaya, bake, yani vinadbo, au vinagin, add, yani vindi, scramble, yani lama vitamin, scramble with alif, scramble, boil, yani vinaslok, okay? We have taken all these words, but now I'm a little. You can put this word, you must put this word into sentences, okay? But I'm a little bit of a woman. So, number one, I want you to write some names of animals. Number two, you are going to describe your house. Three, you are going to write the names of stuff in the kitchen. Four, you are going to make sentences with the names of stuff or verbs we use while cooking. For example, I give an example when I am cooking or when I am in the kitchen, how I blend the fruits. I blend the fruits in the blender. Okay? Number five, answer the questions. How do you peel the potatoes? Two, on what do you cut or slice the meat? Three, how do you squeeze the oranges and lemons? Four, what do you use to blend the fruits? Five, how do you weigh the sugar or flour when you make a cake? Six, you are going to make sentences with these words, rinse, serve, cover, melt, crush, decorate, add, cut, fry, taste, drain, roast, measure, pour, toast, slice, bake, add, scramble, and boil. Okay? Next, here I have something very interesting for you, and this you will like surely. Hena bain to hatargemu, translate the following words in Arabic. Hatargemu al-kalam li hena da in Arabic, the Arabic. So I will not translate it for you. You are going to translate it and go back to the lessons and see if you have translated it correctly. أنا مش هترجمه دلوقتي. أنتوا هتدوروا في الدروس القديمة لو مش فاكرين مش عارفين الكلمة وهترجموه بالعربي. Okay? So the first word is boss. The boss. The boss is the person who we work at him, okay? Employee. The employee is the person who works in an office. Director. Director directs the job. Secretary does secretarial things. The supervisor supervises the job, the work. Assistant. The assistant is the person who helps, is called an assistant. Telephonist who answers on the phone. Postman, the postman brings the letters. Housewife, the wife, the lady who is in the house and cooks and has children and is married, is a housewife. Reporter says the news or writes news. Friend, my friend. Farmer, the farmer who works in the farm. Engineers make buildings, electricity, they work in different jobs. The journalist works in a journal, in the newspaper, journalist. The shoemaker fixes the shoes. The carpenter works with wood, he makes furniture. The salesman sells things. The mechanician fixes the cars or machine. The gardener takes care of the flowers in the garden. The pilot flies the airplane. The captain is the captain of the ship. Writer is the person who writes stories. Surgeon is the doctor who works as a surgeon. He makes operations. Pediatrician is the doctor for kids. Pathologist is the doctor for everything, for colds, for pains. Dentist, the doctor for the teeth. Professor works in the faculty, the professor. Worker is a person who works in a factory. Surgeon again, you have taken it. The orthopedic is the doctor of the bones. Dr. Azam, I translated one. The air hostess works in the aeroplane. Manicurist, she makes the nails. The housekeeper is the person who takes care of the house. The farmer, again. Cashier is the person who takes the money. Friend, we took it before. Engineer, again. Writer. The mother-in-law, the pupil, student, the colleague is the person who works with you at the job, the brother-in-law is the husband of your sister, is the brother-in-law. And the grandfather, the boss, and the director. Okay? So this is all our test. I hope you can do it easily and have a good luck with you for your test. How do you say my test? If you don't know something, all you have to do, go back to the other lessons, you will find your answer. Okay? Good luck with your test. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. See you next time with our new lesson. Enjoy the rest of your day.